Hey everyone, welcome to the 11th episode of the VIO Terminal Classroom. So in this episode, I will teach you how to use the built-in IR emitter on the VIO Terminal and build a simple TV remote for your TV. So now, let's get started. At first, I will talk about what infrared light is. So this is the electromagnetic spectrum, and it consists of different waves such as gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet rays, visible light, infrared rays and radio waves. So out of all these waves, only visible light is visible to the human eyes. So therefore, all the other waves are invisible to the human eyes. So infrared rays belongs to this region of the electromagnetic spectrum, and you can feel these waves as heat because all objects emit infrared radiation. So when you want to transmit infrared rays, you need to have a clear line of sight, because if there is any obstacle, these waves cannot travel through obstacles. Infrared rays has a frequency between 400 terahertz to 300 gigahertz, and they have a wavelength between 700 nanometers and 1 millimeter. So what is an infrared emitter? So an infrared emitter consists of an LED that can be used to transmit infrared signals. So where are these infrared emitters used? So normally we use infrared emitters in remote controllers such as TV, AC, fan and other appliances. So this is the Grove infrared emitter, and you can see there's an LED. So this LED is used to transmit the infrared signals. So if you want to know about this kind of Grove modules, you can visit this page and have a look at many different Grove modules that we offer in the Grove family. So this is the VIO terminal, and it has an infrared emitter on board. So you can see here to the left of the micro SD card slot, there is an infrared emitter. So here you can see the different specifications of the infrared emitter that is used inside the VIO terminal. And if you visit the variant.h file, you can find the infrared emitter pin definitions. So if you go to this location, you can find the variant.h file, or else you can search here in the search bar for the variant.h file. So now let's open this and let's search for IR. So here you can see the IR sensor, and it is defined as VIO IR. So when we want to use this IR emitter with Arduino, we need to make sure to include VIO IR as the pin definition. Now let's look at how to use the IR emitter on the VIO terminal as a remote for your TV. So you can follow the same procedure what I'm about to show you now to use the IR emitter to control other electronic appliances with an IR receiver, such as an AC, a DVD player or any other appliances. So now I will show you the steps of building a TV remote using the IR emitter on the VIO terminal. So first we will use the original TV remote and send modulated IR signals to the IR receiver, which is the Grove IR receiver connected to the VIO terminal. So when we press different buttons on the TV remote, it will send unique IR signals corresponding to the button that we pressed on the TV remote. After that, the Grove IR receiver will convert the modulated IR signals to binary signals and then send these binary signals to the VIO terminal. Then we will use the IR emitter on the VIO terminal to send the raw signals that we received before to control the TV. Now let's look at what we are going to need to build this project. So we will be needing a VIO terminal for sure, and then we will need an IR receiver. So here in this video I will use the Grove IR receiver, but however, if you have a different IR receiver module, you can use that as well. Finally, you need your original TV remote. At first, we will be sending modulated IR signals from the TV remote to the IR receiver. So to start, we have to connect the Grove IR receiver to the Grove digital port on the VIO terminal. So this is the Grove digital port, and let's connect the IR receiver to this port. However, if you don't have a Grove IR receiver, you can use any other IR receiver module and connect it to the 40-pin GPIO header of the VIO terminal. So you can follow this diagram to make the connections. After making the necessary connections, we need to configure the necessary software. So first we need to download and install the infrared library. So let's go ahead to this link first. I will attach this link in the video description down below. And download it as a zip file. After that, open Arduino. Go to Sketch, Include Library and add.zip library. And point to the location you just downloaded the library. So this is the library. So open it. And now you have successfully installed the library. So this is the code that we're going to use to receive the IR signals. So I will give a link to this code in the video description down below so that you can also copy and paste this code into your Arduino IDE. So I will briefly go through this code. So here I have included the IR remote library that we have installed before, and we have defined the IR receive pin and we have configured the IR receiver. After that, we have written here the codes to dump out the decode results. So later we can use this raw data in our IR emitter Arduino code to send signals to the TV. Let's upload this code to the board first. Open serial monitor. So now let's use the remote, point to the IR receiver and press the buttons that we need to control the TV. So as you can see, the raw data gets printed on the serial monitor. So now I will copy this raw data and paste it into a notepad. So now I will make some adjustments to this data. So I will rename this as power, so because it was the power button, and this was the mute button, so mute, and then this was volume up, volume down, channel up and channel down. Now that we have obtained the raw signal data from the IR receiver, we will continue to write our codes for the IR emitter on the VIO terminal. So let's start by including the IR remote library that we have installed before. So hashtag include irremote.h. So I will comment here library. And let's initialize the IR emitter by typing irsend. After that, we will copy and paste the raw data that we obtained before. So raw data arrays, and we will copy this and paste it here. After that, inside the setup, we will configure the buttons and the 5-way switch as inputs for the TV remote that we are going to build. So we will use these 3 buttons and the 5-way switch as inputs. So we will comment here, configuring the buttons and the 5-way switch as inputs. So let's go ahead and write pin mode, VIO key A, and let's set it as an input. After that, we will continue to configure the rest of the buttons and the 5-way switch. So here I have only configured 2 buttons and 4 different positions of the 5-way switch because we will be only sending 6 different signals. So here power, mute, volume up, volume down, channel up and channel down. Now let's move on to the loop. So let's write for the power button first. So power button. So let's write an if loop. So if digital read VIO key A, if it's low, that means it is pressed. IR send dot send raw. So this is the array power, this one power, and next will be the array length, so it's 71, so 71, and then is the carrier frequency. So we will set it as 38 kilohertz. So this is measured in kilohertz and normally it is 38 kilohertz. So here we will comment detecting the button press, and here is pass the array. After that is array length and carrier frequency. Now let's add a delay of 100 milliseconds. So we have just configured this button as the power button, and now we will move on to setting this button as the mute button. So we will use this pin definition YOKB. So we'll go back to this and let's comment here mute button. So let's write else if digital read YOKB, set it to low. If it's low, then send the signal, IR signal, IR send, send raw. Type mute, that's the array, so this one, mute. Array length is 71 and the carrier frequency is 38. Let's add another delay of 100 milliseconds. So now let's set for the volume up. So volume up switch. So we will use the 5-way switch here. So here we will use the up position for the volume up, down position for the volume down. So let's write else if digital read. So here will be while 5s up. If it's low, then IR send dot send raw will be wall up. So here, this one, this array with a 71 length and 38 carrier frequency. Let's finish with a delay of 100 milliseconds. Now let's set for the volume down. So volume down switch. So else if digital read YO 5S down. If it's low, then IR send dot send raw. So here I'll use wall down here. Wall down. Array length is 71 and carrier frequency 38. And then the delay, I will set it as 100 again. So now I will set for the channels. So the switch position right, I will set it as channel up. And for the switch position left, I will set it as channel down. So we will go back to the Arduino code. Let's type channel up switch. So else if digital read YO 5S right. So if it's low, then send the signal. So here will be channel up, so CH up. CH up, array length 71 and carrier frequency 38. Set a delay of 100 milliseconds. Finally, let's add for the channel down. So channel down switch. Else if digital read YO 5S left. So if it's low, then send the signal dot send raw. So here will be CH down. same 71 array length, and the query frequency 38. The delay will be 100. Now let's upload this code to the board. So now we are going to expand this project further by building a simple user interface on the LCD screen of the Vio terminal for the remote controller. So here we will be mainly using shapes and text strings to build this user interface. So we will use the same code that we used before and do some modifications. So at first, let's include the TFT ESPi library because we will be using the LCD screen of the Vio terminal. So TFT LCD library, and let's initialize the TFT LCD library by typing TFT ESPi TFT. Then we will create a buffer. So TFT ESPrite SPR equals TFT ESPrite and TFT. So this is initializing the buffer. So now we will move on to the setup. So here we will keep this and we will add the LCD initializations to, so TFT.begin. So that's LCD initialization. After that, let's type tft.setRotation, set it to 3, and that is setting LCD rotation. After that, type spr.createSprite tft height and tft width. So this is creating the buffer. Now let's start drawing shapes and text strings on the LCD screen. So let's open this. So first let's set the background color to white. So spr.fillSprite tft white and setting background color. After that, we will create this title, the TV remote title, with the blue color rectangle. So creating TV remote title. So first let's draw the blue color rectangle. So fill rect. So fill rect is to draw a fill rectangle. And let's start at here, 00 location, 00. The length will be 320. And the height will be 45 and the color will be blue. So drawing rectangle with blue fill. Now let's draw the text string. So first of all, let's change the text size. So set text size and set it to 3. Setting text size. Then let's set a text color. Set text color and set it to white. Finally, let's draw the text string. So the string will be TV remote and the location will be 80x and 10y. After that, we will draw for the power button and the mute button. So draw power button So first let's set the text size to 2 and text color to black. After that, draw a circle. So draw a circle. So that should draw this. So here I will just draw a circle outline, because when I press the button, I want this to fill in red color. So initially it will be just a circle outline in red color. So the circle, I want it to start at 57x, 90y, and the radius will be 40, and the color will be red. After that, I will draw the text string. So the text string will be power, and it will start at 30x location and 85y location. Now I will draw for the mute button. So draw mute button, and I will draw a circle like before. So draw circle. So 57x, 180y, 40 radius, and I want the color to be blue. So this will be a blue color outline. And the string, I want it to be mute. Location 35x and 175y. Now let's draw this vertical line. So draw vertical line. So I'll write spr dot draw fast v line, and the starting location will be 115x 0y, and the length will be 240 pixels, and the color will be blue color. Now let's draw for the channel buttons here. So draw channel buttons. So first let's change the text size to 3 and draw text string. Spr.draw string. The string will be ch. So this ch, location 155x and 125y. Then let's draw this circle. So spr.draw circle. 173x, 85y, 25 radius, and the color will be dark green. So same as here, same as this circle, it will be a circle with a green color outline. And let's draw the red circle here. So spr.draw circle, 173x, 185y, same radius, 25, and the color will be red color. So finally, let's draw for the volume buttons. So draw volume buttons. Let's first draw the string. So spr.draw string, and the string will be vol. Location will be 230x and 125y, and I will draw this circle now. So spr.draw circle, location will be 250x, 85y, and 25 radius. The color will be TFT, dark green. And do the same for this, the red color circle. So draw circle, 250x, 185y, 25 radius, and the color will be red. So now we have finished setting up the user interface for the TV remote, and now it's time to go to the loop. So inside the loop, we will do some modifications. So after we send this power signal, we will add another line, tft.fillCircle and 57x, 90y, 40 radius, and color will be red. So this is to fill circle with red color. So initially this circle will only have a red color outline. So once you press this power button, this circle will fill in red color. So we'll change this delay to 1000 milliseconds, which is 1 second. Next, we will move on to the mute button. So for the mute button, let's type tft.fillCircle 57x 180y 40 radius, and the color will be blue. So here when the mute button is pressed, this circle will fill in blue color, and let's add a delay of 1 second. After that, let's move on to the volume up switch. So for the volume up switch, tft.fillCircle, the location will be 250x 85y 25 radius, and the color will be dark green, and let's add the delay of 1 second. Now for the volume down switch, let's fill the circle. Fill circle 250x 185y 25 radius, and fill it with red color. Change the delay to 1 second. Finally, let's move on to the channel up and down switches. So for the channel up, tft.fillCircle, let's fill it at 173x 85y 25 radius, and fill it with dark green, and change the delay to 1 second. And finally, for the channel down, tft.fillCircle 173x 185y 25 radius, and the color will be red, and change the delay to 1 second. So now we will push this to the LCD screen. So spr.pushSprite. So push to LCD, and then let's add a delay of 50 milliseconds. And now let's upload this code to the board. So that's it for this video. If you guys like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay updated with us. So, see you guys in the next video.